Okay, now let's see one more problem of the same pentagonal pyramid. Let us straight away go to the problem. Pentagonal pyramid, same data, side of base 30 mm, height 65 mm, and an edge of base is parallel to VP. And solid rests on is given. Here one of the edge of base is parallel to VP. In the previous problem, one of the edges is perpendicular to VP. Here it is parallel to VP. Next, a section plane, sectional plane 40 degrees inclined to HP cuts the solid at a distance of 35 mm above the base. Draw sectional top view, true shape of the section. Here, as I told, first we have to look at the statements given for projection of solid, next statement given for the sectional plane, next what is the question. These are all the three categories of the data we have to look at from any problem in the case of section of solids. It is a pentagonal pyramid, side 30 mm, this is the side 30 mm, and height 65 mm, vertical height is 65 mm, and an edge of the base is parallel to VP. Here one of the edge which I have taken parallel to VP, therefore the solid lies like this, rests on HP. A sectional plane 40 degrees inclined to HP, here perpendicularity is not mentioned. It means that we know for any cutting plane it should be perpendicular to one plane. It may be parallel or inclined or perpendicular to the other plane, therefore here inclined to HP is given. It means that it should be perpendicular to VP, it should be perpendicular to VP and inclined at 40 degrees to HP. Therefore your cutting plane comes like this, perpendicular to VP, that is known. Therefore when you look from the front, it will be seen as a line. Therefore we have to introduce the cutting plane as line in the front view, and then we have to project the top view. 35 mm above the base, here where it passes, it will be 35 mm above the ground, above the base. This is where it passes, sectional top view. This portion is to be removed and we have to look at from the top. We have to draw the sectional top view, and as the cutting plane is inclined, we have to look at a direction perpendicular to this sectional plane to view the true shape of the section, and it has to be projected on an axillary plane which is projected parallel to this cutting plane at the bottom, as like our first problem. Therefore let me do first the projection of solid. That is here given, solid is one of the base side is parallel to VP, therefore this I have drawn parallel to VP. Next, based on this we have to construct the remaining portions of our solid. And we have to name the corners. This is A, B, C, D, E, O. This completes the top view. One of the edges parallel to VP. And then we have to project its corners to get the respective front view. here this corner is my A dash, this is visible, and E dash, it is invisible, and this is P dash visible, C dash visible, and D dash invisible, and then O will come over the top at a height of 65 mm. Here the edge OB and axis comes in the same line, therefore the edge takes the dominancy, therefore I have to draw the edge rather than axis. In the previous problem we have drawn the axis because there is no edge in that place, therefore we have drawn the axis here. But here in the same place we have the axis and also the edge OB, therefore I have drawn the edge OB. Now I have to connect all these apex points with the base corners. Here OA, both the corners are visible, therefore I have drawn it by continuous line. OB already connected, then OC, both are visible, continuous line, and OD, when to connect OD, O is visible and D is invisible, therefore I have to connect it by dotted lines. Whenever to connect two corners, if one is invisible, the line connecting with that, with any corner, is invisible. Therefore next is OE. Here O is visible, E is invisible, therefore this is also to be connected by short dashes. This completes the projection of given pentagonal pyramid. Next I have to introduce the cutting plane 40 degrees to HP and at a point 35 mm above the base. From here read 35 mm above the base, it is fixed. Here through this point I have to draw a 40 degree line. Here I have drawn, and I have to mark the cutting points as like previous cases. From left to right I have to mark the visible cutting points, then from right to left I have to mark the invisible cutting points continuously. Here the first edge OA is cut at 1 dash, it is visible. Next this is invisible and here comes it is visible. The edge OB is cut by 2 dash. Next this is invisible, therefore here the next visible point is OC, this is my 3 dash. And this is now all the visible cutting points are over. Next we have to come back from invisible cutting points. This invisible cutting point is OD, this is my 4 dash invisible, and here this is my 5 dash invisible cutting points. Now we have marked all the visible and invisible cutting points. Next we have to connect all these cutting points by continuous straight line. I have connected, and this portion will be removed, the bottom portion remaining is existing. We have completed the sectional front view. Next, the same cutting points in the respective edges are to be brought down to the respective edges of the top view to get the sectional top view. Here from one draw a vertical line to meet OA. From one draw a vertical line, it means at one, and two, when I am drawing from two, it takes all the points of OB. Therefore here a new procedure that we have to see in this problem, that is whenever such a case comes, you have to take it to the extreme generator or extreme edge, extreme slant edge, by drawing a horizontal line, or otherwise here from 2 dash draw a horizontal line to meet this extreme slant edge, from here draw a vertical line to this, and then from here OS center, this has radius, draw an arc to meet this. This point is my 2. How we have drawn 2? From 2 dash draw horizontal line to the extreme slant edge, either left side or the right side. Right side is convenient, therefore I am drawing this horizontal line from 2 dash to this extreme edge. At this point, from here draw a vertical line to this OC, because OC is the extreme, therefore to this OC I have drawn. And then from here OS enter, this is radius, draw an arc to meet this OB at 2. This is how we have to bring in the point 2. Next 3, from 3 draw a vertical line to meet this OC. Next 4 is on the edge of OD, therefore this is 4. Next 5 is on the edge of OE, therefore this is 5. Now we have taken all the cutting points to the top view. Now I have to connect all the cutting points by continuous line. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 1. This I finished. Now this portion I have removed. This portion is existing. That is 1 to A is existing. Therefore I have to do it by H pencil. Then 2 to B, this portion is existing. Likewise 3 to C is existing. 4 to D is exist. 5 to E is exist. And all the base corners and the base edges are available. Therefore, this is also to be drawn by H pencil. AB, BC, CD, DE, EA. And then the cut surface bounded by this cutting point is to be hatched. This is called a sectional surface. This we are doing. This completes the sectional top view. Now a front view we have drawn and a sectional top view we have completed. Next we have to take the true shape of the section. To take the true shape of the section, we know that we have to remove this portion and we have to look at a direction perpendicular to this section plane from here. For that I have to introduce an axillary plane here, x1 y1, which is parallel to this. Therefore here I am introducing a plane parallel to this. This is my x1 y1. This is parallel to cutting plane. Next, from here I have to draw perpendicular lines from these cutting points towards this. From 1 draw perpendicular line, from 2 draw perpendicular line, from 3 draw perpendicular line, from 4 and then from 5. Here all these lines are perpendicular. Next, to mark these cutting points here, I have to measure what is the vertical distance of 1 from XY. This I have to measure and fix it here. This is my 1. And then 2, this I have to measure and I have to mark it here as 2. Next 3, this I have to measure and I have to mark it on 3. On this point, I have to mark this 3, 3. Next 4 is on this. This is the line from 4. This I have to mark it as 4. Next 5 here. I have got all these cutting points and the respective lines drawn from here. Now I have to connect these cutting points by continuous thick line. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 1. This is the true shape of the section and this is also to be hatched by a 45 degree line to the boundary. Now this completes the true shape of the section also. Next, as usual, we have to mark the given dimensions. Here it is given that the base side is 35 mm and the height of the solid is 65 mm and height of this point is 35 mm above the base and this angle is 40 degrees. These are all the data given in the problem. This completes. Here, this is the new information in this problem. When a edge, if from cutting point 2 dash, if it comes all the points of OB, what I have to do? From 2, draw a horizontal line to the extreme edge, either right side extreme edge or the left side extreme edge, and from there produce the line vertically to the respective edge, and then from there draw an arc to meet the respective edge. This is the new information in this problem. Here, as the section plane is inclined, we have to draw the true shape of the section. And here in the problem, it is not given that to which it is perpendicular. But we know fundamentally a section plane should be perpendicular to one of the planes. Therefore, it is sufficient when we give whether it is inclined or parallel or perpendicular to the other plane. It is enough. Because so far in the previous problems, we have seen section plane perpendicular to one plane and parallel or inclined to the other plane. But here only inclination is given. Perpendicularity is not mentioned in the problem, but that is sufficient. And while looking at the asked data itself, we could able to see. Here in the asked data, it is asked the sectional top view. Sectional top view means here we will have to introduce the cutting plane as a line so that we will get a sectional top view here. If it is asked that sectional front view, as like in this previous problem, sectional front view is asked, it means that the hatching surface comes in the front view. Therefore, in the top view, I have to introduce the section plane. If you have any small confusion by reading this information of the sectional plane, you can refer it from this itself also, from the asked data itself also, we could able to confirm certain thing. Here it is asked sectional front view. It means that the hatching surface comes in the front view. It means that the horizontal cutting plane we have to introduce in the top view. Here horizontal cutting plane or inclined cutting plane I have to introduce in front view so that I will get sectional top view. And here there is no true shape of the section because already this sectional front view itself is true because it is a horizontal cutting plane, therefore which is drawn perpendicular, which is looked at from here at a perpendicular direction. Therefore this itself is true. But here in this problem, here it is inclined cutting plane, therefore we have to look at in a direction perpendicular to this, and it has to be projected on an axillary plane which is introduced parallel to the cutting plane. That is, what is this x1 y1, and therefore this is only the sectional top view. This is the true shape of the section. We will see the remaining things in the next class.